It's BYC Gaming. We're back once again. We got a Massachusetts matchup on the way.
Home of the Boston College Eagles, where fans are filing into Alumni Stadium. They'll look between the field hockey lines, perhaps underneath the Musco lighting that's been imported in, and hope that there will be a party in the moment. This matchup today, part of the lifeblood of the sport, a rivalry game where the results will be remembered for a lifetime. As we'll see, the UMass Minutemen taking on a team from the ACC, the Boston College Eagles. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Time to get this game started. UMass will kick off and we'll be underway.
All right, we got this matchup of two teams from Massachusetts. Boston College gets things going with the return to the 24.
So the Boston College Eagles offense takes the field for the first time today. These rivalry games can really get the blood pumping, and we'll see who can manage their emotions best early.
Everyone's been waiting for this game, right? You know, both of these teams have had this game circled all the way back to the beginning of the offseason, so you got to be able to play under control.
With passion, with energy, with hatred, because it's a rivalry game, but keep your emotions in check and making sure I'm controlling what I can control.
Finds Zach Freeze, and he's got four out to the 29.
That's a really nice play. It's impressive. When it's first down and the defense thinks you might be running the football, you still can line up. You can get some movement at the point of attack and find a little crease for your running back.
After the productive first down play, it's second and six. Buys a little extra time. Got a man. It's McGowan. Quick step and go.
Let's go, McGowan. Okay. I like that.
Running the drag route against zone coverage, finding the soft spot, making it easy on his quarterback to get the completion. He turns it upfield and he moves the sticks.
They have had to wear that beat down since the last time these two met, Jesse.
And they've been talking about it for a long time. They were absolutely embarrassed. The players, the coaches, the fans. You know, David, coming into this game this time, they want to put out a much better performance.
Oh, there's nothing worse. The coaches are riding you all week leading up into this game, reminding you, showing the clips in the locker room. You know you failed. You want to come out and get a great start in this football game.
Well, it's a nice play design there. You're getting the running back involved in the pass game. Quarterback gives it to him early so he can go to work upfield and get the first down.
Out of the gun to give to the back. Pass the sticks and still on his
so
feet.
Far, so good with Boston College moving the ball well.
Pick up of 10 and a first down. And the Golden Eagles come to the line with a fresh set of downs. Grabbed in the backfield. It's Globichill. And that play just looked to be a mess from the snap, and he's run out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage. And now on second down for this offense. He's looking to throw. Get it out on the screen. Bounced off his feet.
This defense is going to have to be careful. Not only do they have to worry about this guy running the football, but they got to keep their eye on him when he runs.
All right, big third down.
He is a versatile back.
On third and short, they'll ride the
push, push.
And they're able to get a third down stop here. See if they go for it on fourth. This offense wants to get out of the gate fast on their first drive of the game, plus territory. They'll go for it. They got him. It's a sack.
Good defense. I should have just ran that one. Good job.
So offense will try to get something going with their first possession. As we take a look at our impact players for this game, David, what do you look for to make an impact from your leaders?
Your leaders not only have to lead the football team, but they got to step up and make plays on the field, keep everybody calm. These guys typically do a really good job of it.
Yeah, David, and they also generally set the tone for their respective football teams. Regardless of which side of the ball they play on, the teammates look towards them to step up in big games like this.
Looking for a crease to the left. And maybe he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. A I know you want to prepare for every game the same way, but there's just something different about rivalry games, Jesse.
It's because, Reese, I think players are aware that games like this define your legacy as a player. Your record in rivalry games is something that people are going to talk about for years and years down the road. You have got to show up and play your best football in games like this.
Looking for a gap. It's John. A run up the middle is stopped for no gain. Got stuck.
Good
on
defense,
first down,
fellas.
And he's looking to throw. Just a short pass to the tight end. They stop him almost immediately. Short gain there. Still a little ground to cover to pick up the first. Trying to move the sticks on third down. Wants to throw. It's Kumachan. Quickly complete. And he's knocked down immediately, but not before he moves the chains.
Really nice job there by the quarterback, understanding that it's zone coverage on third down. You're going to have to find someone working into a soft spot. Get the ball out of your hands quickly. Make an accurate throw.
Good pass. Right to the one.
He is down at the one. A terrific run after the throw and catch. UMass lines up with a first and goal. He'll just keep slinging it. Snagged in the end zone.
I don't know what happened. I tried to call a timeout. We came out in field goal block form, and they got us.
Against a rival, doesn't it?
No doubt. In a game like this, too, you just want to be executing it at a high level early. So, David, that's got to feel great getting on the board first.
And settles everywhere down. All the nerves, all the emotion of this rivalry game. Now everybody can kind of settle in because you know you already got a touchdown on the board.
And the extra point is good, and it's 7-0.
All right, so the early mistake costs us. We come with the all-out blitz by accident, and that leads to an easy touchdown pass to the wide-open receiver. Let's get back on offense and try to answer that touchdown drive.
And he takes this from inside the five. And good work by the coverage team to get the return man down on the ground. BC has the ball back, hoping for a party in the mods. You could probably question the decision to pass on a field goal last time, and they came up empty on that previous drive, Jesse.
I just think in this offense, it's going to come down to critical down and distances, right? Down in the red zone, third down, fourth down. I like them being aggressive. They just got to do a better job executing.
Yeah, and they kind of know what the defense gave them last time. So let's be more aggressive and take advantage of that defense on this drive.
Looking downfield, it's Castellanos. He spins that thing down the middle.
Beautiful catch.
Man, this offense is so dangerous, Reese.
First down.
That can make plays. There's a big gainer in the pass game.
You get a chunk of yards like that, now the defense is really on its heels. Offense threatening at the 45-yard line on first and 10. Leaves it with the running back. And he broke one tackle on the way to a solid pickup there.
Yeah, this coaching staff, they're getting this offensive line lathered up and into a rhythm. Now they're letting them drive off the ball on first down on these running plays, and they're getting chunks of yardage.
He's looking for a man on second down. Caught on the outside, it's Franklin. He steps out of bounds, but he's got a first down on the play. The Golden Eagles come to the line with a new set of downs. Looking to go up top on first down. They'll throw it to the back on the screen. Jukes his way for more. And the completion gives him a fresh set of downs and keeps this drive moving.
Great job, too, by the QB there. Holding the ball as long as possible, allowing the pass rush to get upfield, and at the very last second, getting it to his guy so that he can go get the first down.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
Quarterback now on the run, still looking. With the catch, it's Franklin.
All right, so that'll be the last play of the first quarter. We look good in that first quarter. We're down seven. We have a chance to tie it up starting the second.
That's the end of the quarter, and it's UMass holding the lead. And we've come to the end of the first as we take a moment to check. Check out the stats so far. They are lined up and ready to go and get things started here in the second. Back at it to open the quarter with this first down play. They'll give it to the back.
And a nice job by the running back, finding space, getting downhill, making the good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
Going to work on second down in the red zone is still some ground to cover to pick up that first down. Trying to get the edge on the toss.
Good play by the defense right there.
Well tackled in the backfield for a loss of six.
You know, you're in the red zone, you bring out a bunch of tight ends on the field. So the defense, they were expecting run on that one. They were physical, and they were able to force the negative play.
Now he's going to glide away from pressure. Makes the grab on the left. And he'll haul it.
I didn't think he was going to get in the end zone. I knew he had the first down, but we'll take it. Let's go.
Start for this offense.
On to attempt a try. And it's up and good. After that latest answer, tied things up, just about set to kick it away again. Bringing it back. I imagine he's going to get an earful on the sideline after bringing it out of the end zone and being knocked. The Minutemen going back to work on offense. After standing on the sideline and watching that long touchdown drive, they really need to put something together to give their defense a rest.
And that's a real thing, man. Like, you played a lot of plays, you get worn out, you need a chance to go decompress on the sideline, get some oxygen. Palmer, now it's on this offense.
Yeah, this is the definition of complementary football, because it's a two-pronged problem. You've got to score points and answer, but you've also got to take your time and give your defense an opportunity to get their win.
Running back searching for a hole.
Good tackle.
There's a statement by the defensive front. First down play, expecting run, and they just dominated up front. Beat their one-on-ones and forced a tackle for a loss.
Takes the handoff. It's John.
And a nice second effort by the back to break a tackle. But how about those defensive backs willing to come up, stick their face in the fan, and make a tackle?
Those are the best run defenses, too, right? It's not just D-linemen and linebackers getting all the plays, but it's DBs that are willing to not just cover, but tackle backs in the open field.
And he's not going to make it. The defense denying him the first down. UMass will line up to punt it away. Getting our first look of the afternoon at the punter. Good job by the coverage unit to put a stop to that return. Boston College sending the offense back onto the field. This could be a real turning point in the game. They scored a touchdown. They got a stop. And now a chance to break the tie.
Yeah, this offense has got it cooking, man. And how about the defense? Great job getting that stop, getting the football right back to the hot hand. Now this offense, Palmer, has a chance to take the lead.
You can see the offense, too. They understand the situation right now. They were jonesing on the sidelines to get another opportunity to run back on the field. They are ready to drive this ball and go score.
Nice pass, first down.
But not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. And he finds some solid space, makes a nice game before the defense is able to stop it.
Coaches always harp about staying ahead of the chains, and when you can run with that type of efficiency on first down, man, you are doing just that.
They're working that left side. He's got enough to give Boston College the first down.
I like the slot receiver because it gives his quarterback a good option working the middle of the field. He's a nice weapon in this offense.
Making sure they have good balance, keeping it on the ground.
All right, well, the offense here, they're trying to get this run game established. They obviously don't break off a long run there, but they're just trying to find their footing at this point.
didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine. Dropping back, it's Castellanos. Quarterback now breaking the field. Trying to make magic on the scramble. Finally run out of bounds, but he
is scramble, homie.
With a first down.
Man, that's so frustrating. And it happens so fast. He just pulls it down. It looks like pass. He pulls it down, and he's gone. Just like that, chewing up yards. So much speed, so hard to stop.
The give to the tailback. You'll take this every time, 5 yards on the first down play.
I like it. Just frustrate the defense. Get that 5 to 6 yards. Make them honor the run. Make them know that you're willing to run the football and run it effectively.
Caught in the backfield. It's Franklin. They get him down after he makes the catch.
Nice screen to the tight end.
An example of a tight end doing a little unheralded work to set up a much better third down situation.
And I like the QB here, Reese. I like the decision where I understand, let's get this football out, let's get some positive yards, and then get to third down, and we can still have a better situation now because we got rid of the football and took the yards that were there.
BC back to work after picking up the first down. He's going to pass. Setting up the screen. And they wrap him up, but not before he's got enough for the first down.
Hey, man, sometimes you get the perfect play call at the perfect time. That time, the defense blitzing, offensive line allowed everybody to run upfield, and they slip in the running back screen, and behind it, there was nobody there to make a tackle. And this offense generates a massive play.
I'm just trying to find ways to manufacture extra yards, right? I just get a couple extra in the red zone, and then I get that touchdown that I'm searching for. So I like it. It wasn't ultra productive, but it's a
threw it to the wrong man. We had somebody open in the corner.
And they've got him down after the short completion, but they inch closer and closer to Pater. Well, they've gotten it down to the 3, but now it's 3rd and goal. To the air, it's Castellanos. For the score. Touchdown, Boston College.
And that is exactly what you want from your offense. Man, late in the half, you want to execute and then punch it in physically on the ground. Take the lead going into the half. Take all the momentum. Nice execution of the drive by that offense.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the PAT gives them
all right, let's get it. 70 seconds left in the first half. Let's make sure we don't give up any points to UMass here before we head into halftime.
The returner will field it and bring it back. And the coverage team able to make the tackle. The UMass offense returns to the field. That last drive won't go on the highlight reel after ending in a punt. They'd like to be more productive this time, David.
And I think this offense has to be a little bit more balanced.
Good hands by the corner right there.
I think too, David, it's just going to take a smart. It just takes one play to get this thing picked up and off.
On second down, he'll let it fly. Fires a bullet out.
Give me that. Give me that.
Coaching staff there defensively, matching the personnel of the offense, putting their dime package out on the field. So you bring out the extra defensive back. You're anticipating a pass. Perfect timing to run that personnel, and you get the pick.
BC has it back, and the Eagle offense returns to the field. They took their time out of the gate, but now starting to try to take control of this game on offense here in the second quarter, Jesse.
Yeah, and they're playing good complementary football up to this point. This is a huge opportunity, David, for them to really create some momentum.
Well, and the defense did such a good job keeping them in the game early. Now holding down their end. Now get the offense rolling, put up some points on the scoreboard, and then you can really get dangerous in this ballgame.
They've got the screen set up. And there were no creases or crevices to run through, and they shove him out of bounds.
This offense will screen you in a variety of ways. They'll throw receiver screens, tight end screens. The running back screen also a big part of what they like to do, like you just saw there.
Looking to throw, it's Castellanos. He's got him in the flat. He's brought down, but he went backwards after that completion, not the way they had it drawn up.
And listen, if I'm the quarterback, I'm trying to dump the ball off to my playmaker and make this a manageable third down. Get something positive. But how about the defense just reacting so fast, getting to the running back, and getting that sucker on the ground in the open field?
Leaves it with the back. Nice move to stay on his feet. And he's not going to get there. The defense stands tall and makes the stop.
All right, we'll let the clock get down to about 2 or 3 seconds, and we'll try the 48-yard field goal attempt before we head into the half.
Quick timeout from the offense to save precious seconds.
Timeout, Boston College.
Just a few seconds to go here in the first half, and they'll send out the field goal team. He'll need to strike this one cleanly from 48 yards out.
Shankaroonie.
And the margin remains at 7 after the minute. That's the end of the second quarter. That means it's time to join Kevin in our halftime update.
Thanks so much, guys. And I need not tell you, rivalry games always bring out a ton of emotion. And no surprise, we saw just that in the first half today. And I get it. A lot of coaches will say the difference between winning and losing comes down to stopping big plays and getting big plays. But if you ask me, it's more about how good you are on third down and how efficient you are in keeping drives alive. Those two stats can help you break the will of even the best defenses and help you come out on top.
Boston College ready to kick things off and start the second half. He'll bring it out. It's Brown. Gets it out to the 20, about 5 yards short of where he'd be if he'd just taken a knee in the end zone. The Minutemen going back to work on offense. Maybe adjustments or attitude adjustments, but they've got to find a way to run the ball at least some here in the second half.
I do think you said something that's important. I think running the football is an attitude. Like, it starts with the offensive lineman and being physical, having a nasty attitude. Running back, same thing. I think they need more of that in the second half.
You know, and I think if you're this defense, you have an opportunity to make a statement here. Yeah, I know you guys went in at halftime and you riled yourselves up and you told yourself that you think you can run the ball on us. On this very first drive, we're going to prove to you, just like in the first 30 minutes, you cannot.
Gets it out fast. He stopped it.
Nice pass right there from UMass. First down, and they're back in the hurry up.
UMass quickly back to the line.
And that's what I love about this offense. You're not going to get all of your big chunk plays in the passing game by throwing it deep down the field. You can kind of dink and dunk. And on that RPO play, they had it dialed up and set up to go to that player in the right flat. Nice job.
Great defense right there.
Through his fingers, incomplete. That would have been a huge gain if he could have squeezed it. After the misconnection, it's second down. Back to throw, it's Kumachan. And that's going to fall to the ground incomplete. That was a physical matchup there. Third down coming. They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. On third and long, try to convert through the air. Makes a connection. Makes the grab and knocked down, and he's got it at the 25-yard line. UMass getting set to snap it on first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
Everybody talks about DBs. They talk about dropping coverage and not being physical. That DB begs to differ. Great tackle coming up, playing physical like a linebacker.
Trying play action. Got him downfield. And they'll finally catch up to him, but not before a big chunk of yardage is picked up. UMass lines up with a first and goal. Snap in the shotgun. Oh, what a grab by the defense.
Come on, to the house. To the house. Oh. Couldn't beat that guy down the field, but that's a big interception. Taking potential points off the board for Massachusetts. So the 14-7 game with 4:08 left in the third.
The ball back, hoping for a party in the mods. You want to talk about taking the wind out of your sails, drive the ball down the field and miss the field goal, David.
You know what? Don't leave it up to kickers. Execute better offensively. I think you move the ball nice. You got to keep that in mind. But Palmer, I think you got to stay aggressive and don't settle for field goals.
Yeah, because you got to know there's just no margin for error right now. You just have got to be able to execute at a higher level.
Defense there to stop him after a gain of three, but he is inside the 30 to the 29. Remember, they missed a field goal on their last drive, but at the very least, they need to get back in field goal range here on third down. Skips away from pressure. He can't find anybody. It'll be incomplete as the defense does a really good job in coverage.
And the offense tries to slip in the screen. That's a good play on third and short. If you can get them aggressive and the defense aggressive, but the defense sniffed it out, shut that play down before it even started.
No thought of trying to kick the 46-yarder. They'll go for it. On fourth down, they're taking to the air. With the catch, it's Bradley.
Mainly went for it right there because the kicker missed one from similar distance. Just a drive ago, so good job getting the fourth down conversion right there.
Pass. I mean, you got to be aggressive. You got to get touchdowns, man. You've seen the emphasis. Defenses are willing to give up yards now to make you kick field goals. I like this offense being aggressive. Forget the threes. We need sixes.
Again, this is a running back that can hurt you running it between the tackles, and he's dangerous out in space. They like to throw it to him out on the perimeter as he picks up a couple of yards there.
Here's the handoff. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Man, oh, man, am I upset at my offensive line to give up penetration that fast? Man, we blinked and missed it.
Hey, he barely got the ball and just got destroyed immediately. What a great play. Quarterback checking the play. Looking for a man. It's Castellanos. Pocket starts to collapse. How about that nice run from this junior quarterback?
These quarterbacks, they just bounce and bounce and bounce and pull the ball down and make plays. Defensively, you just got to keep coming. You can't get tired. You can't get frustrated, really. It's the frustration that gets to you because they keep making plays and keep getting first downs. Got another opportunity.
Big hit on the quarterback right there.
Well, the QB decided to keep it on that one. And listen, if you had his athleticism, you'd want to keep it too. Almost every time they run these types of option plays. But he's just going to have to do a good job of understanding when to hand it off, when to pitch it, and try to keep this defense on their heels and read his keys. He's got a lot of talent. Just got to make sure he's making the right decisions moving forward.
They'd love to make this short field pay off with a touchdown instead of settling for three, but it is third and goal. Into the hallelujah land. Touchdown, Eagles.
Let's go.
The offense flexes its muscle a bit and widens the gap.
Take a little exhale. You know, you did your job. You got points. Now you put your defense in a position where, hey, go out and get another stop. We're in great shape. So the offense definitely taking care of their business.
Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll start the return inside his five. And they'll bring him down to get the offense started on the next drive. The UMass offense returns to the field. Now we'll get a chance to see if they can answer that last score, trailing by 14, Jesse.
Yeah, and at this point of the game, I feel like offensively, you should go back to what's been working for you in this game. Don't be afraid to dial up plays that you've already had success with, running it and throwing it. It's okay to repeat plays down 14 at this point.
And I would also say, Palmer, kind of understanding that my defense is not playing great, so I know offensively, I got to put some good possessions together here, make something happen on this side of the field.
Really good effort on that one to work his way up to the 42. Solid pickup of four on first down and second and six. Makes makes it past the marker. Slammed to the ground, but not before he gets the first down.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the first down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the first down.
Line getting set on second down. Looking for space. It's John. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3. And this offense just can't afford not to get the first down here. Already trailing big, and the clock is not their friend. On third down, going up top. Oh, they really
good hit. Punt on the way.
Physical pass defense. It brings up a fourth down. UMass will line up to punt it away. It'll go out of bounds, and we'll see where they mark it. It's going to be right around the 35. Boston College sending the offense back onto the field. Really good balance on that last drive. They mixed it up all over the place, Jesse.
Yeah, how nice, too, to have the defense on their heels, because at this point, they don't know what's coming at them. They had problems stopping everything that last drive.
So I think this defense would come back with a little more aggressiveness. I mean, they let them have what they want, and now they got to dictate to this offense a little bit more.
Halfway there on first down, it's 2nd and 5. Looking for a man, it's Castellanos. Trying to escape and get it himself. That pass is incomplete, and they're probably fortunate that it wasn't knocked free for a fumble.
Well, as a quarterback, when you get to the outside, you know you don't have all day to throw. You've got these defenders. They are coming. They're running at you hard. So you've got to do a better job getting the ball out quicker. That hit forced the incompletion.
Fires to the tight end. He will step.
Nice catch by Morales right there. Big play.
As they get set to snap it, just about to reach the end of the quarter.
All right, I was going to call a play. Let's take it into the fourth and close this game out. BC up 21-7 on UMass.
That's the end of the quarter, and Boston College has the lead. They built a comfortable lead after 3 quarters of play. Let's take a look at how we got here. One more quarter to go, and it looks as if we are ready to play. They'll break the seal on this quarter here on first down. He'll do it himself. He has an extensive juke library, and he exhausted it and still didn't pick up much.
You know, as a quarterback, when you're doing this zone read play, you got to read that defensive end. And if he crashes down hard inside to take the running back away, right away you know now you're keeping the football. Nice job by the quarterback.
Looking for room. It's Robichaud. And he didn't have a whole lot of operating room after the juke, and he stopped for a short game. Will they keep it on the ground again here on third down? They'll try to get it through the air. That's reeled in. It's Bradley. Third down.
First down. Move the chains.
They're at the 35. Boy, the defense really needed to get off the field there, and they just couldn't do it, and it's a fresh set of downs.
Man, that hurts. When you're trailing late in the ball game, you need those stops, and you get them to third down. You get them to those critical points. Now they get the first down. You don't have many left. You better get aggressive.
Escapes the pressure going right.
Might be holding on this one. Let's see.
The connection, and it could get worse. A penalty flag on the field, and it's in the holding zone. Let's get the call. We'll repeat the previous down, but this time the offense has 10 more yards it has to cover. Boston College putting together a very efficient drive. Looking for a physical attack from the gun. A strong tackle and wrap up from the junior.
At this point of the game, the
probably should have ran that last one in between the right tackle and the right guard. Tried to cut back to the left.
He's looking at his playlist and he's saying, which runs work the best for me in this game? What can I lean on right here to make sure we win this one?
Hit as he throws. That pass. pass is incomplete, and they might be fortunate it wasn't not free for a fumble. It'll be third down.
The offensive line has got to give him at least a little bit of time to survey the field. He had no chance that time, getting hit almost immediately after he got the ball.
Now improvising. Just threw that one away to avoid disaster.
Every defense in the country talks about getting offenses in predictable third and long situations where I can bring on more speedsters and I know the pass is coming so I can have more success.
Very good punt. Inside the 20. Let's go.
The Minutemen going back to work on offense. They hope to be able to cash in on this drive, David, after having to punt it last time.
Yeah, and I think this offense needs to start.
Let's go, defense. Way to swarm them.
Successful and productive on that first play, and it gets you in less predictable situations.
No doubt, too. Don't you just feel like there's a little bit more sense of urgency on this drive? It just feels like they've got to be able to put some points up on the board here.
And just left that pass.
Good pressure. That one falls to the ground. Come on, defense. One more stop.
Defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on third and long. To the air. It's Pumachan. A little screen to the running back. Across the 25, he's got room. And they'll do more than move the chains. They'll move that thing more than 30 yards down the field before he's finally stopped.
I think if you're the head coach at this point, you're telling your offense, it doesn't matter what's happened up to this point of the game. Obviously, things haven't gone our way, but we have a chance to execute in a two-minute situation.
And the quarterback was trying
Let's
to
go.
Extend the play, and the defense brought it to a close. The DBs will back off a bit. Quarterback wants to throw on second down.
Wow, found a man. Good pass.
And perhaps a touchdown-saving tackle as they get him down at the 37. UMass quickly back to the line.
And no messing around right now if you're on offense. This is the time where execution has got to be at a premium. You need to hit completions, David. They need some big plays.
And you just want to keep pressuring them and keep making them use the clock, give them the underneath stuff, and get them. When they drive the football down the field, I just can't give up touchdowns. Field goal at this point is not going to hurt my defense.
On second down, he's looking downfield. Caught over the middle. It's Brown. They make the stop, trying to pick up just a little bit at a time to get to that first down mark.
Well, and here's the problem offensively, because you're trailing by so much so late in the game, the defense now is going to be playing big zone coverages, and they're going to allow you to throw the ball underneath in the middle of the field, rally to make a tackle, and bleed the clock. It's going to be hard now for this offense to claw their way back in this one.
They absolutely had to have that third down to keep any glimmer of hope alive.
And defensively, that's exactly what I want. Make you get the third down. The clock is your enemy. Multiple possession lead. That is right where I want this offense.
The incompletion leads to second and 10. He's looking to throw. Got it in the middle. It's John.
Guys on the backfield now, it's not just run the ball downhill anymore. You got to be versatile. I got to be able to trust you in the pass game. I got to be able to throw you the football. You can do that right there. I know you're going to catch it, and I can depend on it.
Tight end finds a soft spot.
Let's go. Fourth down. Let's see what they do. They're going to go for it. All right, we got to shut this one down for sure.
And this likely the final snap before the two-minute warning. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Dances away at about
nowhere to go, nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Let's go.
Now trailing with a little over 2 minutes, it's looking bleak. My defense has got to go out there and get a stop immediately. I got to stop the clock as fast as I can, try to save as much as I can, and then put my two-minute offense together. There's a lot that has to go right for me to get back in this ballgame.
One more yard on this second down might just put an exclamation point on this one. They'll run it, trying to drain time off the clock. They knock him down, but they'll mark it beyond the line to gain, and it's a first down for Boston College. Quick timeout called by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. They'll snap this one from the 32. It's first down. Runs through a tackle. Defense uses a timeout quickly, trying to get that ball back and preserve time for their offense. Wouldn't be surprised to see them go right back to the run on second down and maybe put this thing away. Takes a handoff. It's Klobuchar. They get him on the ground, but it's a first down. Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible.
And they've had a day, and it's the complete and total offense. They got the ground going, and obviously this is why you see him. You're going to feature him because he can churn those legs, get those extra yards, but they've had balance throwing for touchdowns. Like, this offense has been very complete today, and that's why they're winning so big.
And they'll take a knee and watch this clock keep on winding.
That was a good W. Very, very good W.
No matter how much college football changes, realignment, all that kind of stuff, rivalries are consistent, and winning rivalry games, well, that's just the best.
Because they hate each other so much. So you take the field against your rival, and you're able to put forth a performance like that. That is worth its weight in gold, David. Unbelievable effort here by the winning team. Bragging rights now.
Bragging rights for a while. It's a fun thing to be able to accomplish. Now we also got to take in the next couple games, because this is always, there's a letdown that naturally happens after these big rivalry wins. We feel like our chest is poked out. We got to look on to the next game, focus in on this next one.
So that's going to do it for us. For Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, I'm Reese Davis saying so long. This has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.
All right, so that was a good one. Boston College comes away with a nice victory. You see the total numbers. Pretty balanced in comparison. Let's look at the player stats real quick. Player of the game, Thomas Castellanos. 22 completions on 27 attempts for 165 yards. Two touchdowns as well. And on the ground, Castellanos had six carries, 25 yards, and a touchdown. Robichaud had a good game as well, the Columbus, Georgia running back. We appreciate y'all rocking out with us here on BYC Gaming. It will be 100 games in 100 days. BC knocked off the list, and they win 21-7. We appreciate all y'all for tapping in with the live one, the playback. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe if you rock with the crew and the things that we do. Until then, peace out, y'all.